So,
okay, please tell us if you can hear us now. Yes. Hopefully we've just made an adjustment.
Absolutely.
That will fix things.
Uh-huh. If you missed the beginning, we talked about my tiny hat that I stole off of an ant.
Yeah, he talked about a tiny hat.
Uh-huh. Okay, here we go.
Okay,
all right,
good.
We have confirmation
for our studio audience that you can hear
us.
Welcome to the show. Welcome if it's your first time viewing us, if it's
if you're
a regular viewer, if you're watching now.
Yeah.
Or in the future, thanks for watching. Welcome to the club. What are all the things we said?
I said, oh, hey, if you're watching in the past, that's nuts.
Whoa, that's crazy. That'd be bonkers. Okay.
That's absolutely nuts.
Now we have even less time.
Uh-huh.
Great. Because now we have even less time. We've lost a few minutes. We have even less time to do our
show. We got to do the bit.
Show.
So here's the bit.
We need your calls tonight.
We need them. Now, should we give them the number?
8024
two hands. 8024
or hit the call now button on our profile. If you're viewing this on your phone, just hit that call now button on our profile. Boom. It's not down there, but that's what
Hello. That's you at home.
Yeah, and we'll answer that phone and we'll take that call and we'll talk about stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And what we're going to be talking about is broken bones.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Now, this is what we have right here. We have this skeleton.
I have this diagram of a skeleton.
Uh-huh. Now, we don't need to break every single bone three times.
No.
We're only going to count
We would like a broken bone story
for
every bone
in the body.
Every bone.
Every single bone.
So encourage everyone you know who's ever broken a bone, especially if someone's broken a strange bone, ask them to call in 8024-2-HANDS or hit the call now button. We're trying to talk to someone who's broken every single one of these bones.
And by the way,
eat one bone per person.
Uh-huh.
But we'd like at the end of the night to cross off this whole skeleton.
Yes, absolutely. Now, keep in mind, you have to have broken a bone. It doesn't have to be your own bone. You can have broken somebody else's bone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
I will say that's within the rules.
If you have ever broken a bone, please call in 8024-2-HANDS or hit the call now button on our profile. If you've ever broken a bone, please call in. We're trying to get a record of broken bones.
Uh-huh.
Hopefully, one entire broken skeleton. If you have if you currently have a broken bone,
that's
a great call. That's a great call.
You are in a situation where you have broken a bone.
Yes.
Now, Harper, have you ever broken a bone?
I don't think I've ever. I mean, not.
You don't think you have?
I don't have confirmation that I have.
What does that mean?
I have thought for a long time that I probably broke my nose at one point. And I mean, I know the point. I'm not saying, like, randomly.
Uh-huh.
But my mom was a nurse, and a lot of times when I was younger, if something didn't feel so good, she'd be like,
pop you in the nose?
No. No, but she'd just sort of be like, see how it feels later. Like,
uh-huh. Sure.
That was, like, her strategy for a lot of things. So
my grandmother was a nurse, and she would just put a stethoscope up to whatever part of my body was hurting.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did that
so
help?
I was like, oh, I got an earache, and she'd just go, yeah, you do.
Wow.
Yeah, it was really, really nuts.
Wow, what a good grandma.
Yeah, she's
yeah,
great.
So one time I was climbing a tree, and then I attempted to jump out of the tree. My foot got caught on the tree, and I fell, like, face forward into, like a root or like a stump, some bit of wood that was also there on the ground. I fell face forward into that. And I do suspect I broke
your nose?
My nose. What, although,
did blood come out of it?
Yeah, blood came out of it.
Sure. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm seeing a comment, can we break bones for this show?
I mean, look.
We cannot condone or endorse that.
Our lawyers have told us that we cannot tell you to break bones.
We can't tell you to break bones, but, like, honestly, no one's called in yet, and we're already, how many, like, 7 minutes into the show?
Uh-huh.
There's no way we finish off this whole skeleton. So please, if you or anyone you know has broken a bone, please
call
in.
Even in the last 7 minutes.
Even if it was just in the last 7 minutes.
Maybe you heard somebody talk about how you wanted to call, they needed you to call into the show, talking about broken bones you've had, and you were like, okay, I'll do that. That sounds fun.
If you want to break a bone live on air during a call.
That would be...
I'm not asking for it, but I will do it.
But we will take that call.
And we would think it was rock and roll.
Yes. This is a punk rock show.
Yeah, and it would be even more so if someone broke a bone.
Oh, that would be insane. We're not going to do it.
Live on air.
I
wouldn't dream of it.
Uh-huh,
not my precious bones.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
Not my precious bones.
Ugh, my bones are too precious.
To me, my bones are worth their weight in bones. I don't want to... I want my bones. Like, Those are valuable, you know?
Yeah, uh-huh. I think my bones might be...
How much do bones weigh? You can go.
I think my bones might be, like, indestructible. Because I've never broken
adamantium
a bone. Yeah, like skeleton. Adamantium bones. Absolutely. But I've never broken a bone, so I don't know what it's like. Please tell me what it's like. I want to know. Do you feel it?
Yeah,
does it hurt?
Does it hurt to break,
does it hurt to break a bone?
To do an injury?
Yeah. To do an injury.
Does it hurt when you do an injury?
Because, like, I've gotten, like, cuts before.
Yeah.
And that hurt.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know about bone. Like, if it happens on the inside, I don't know how much it hurts.
You know, sometimes you know they say a sprain's worse than a break.
Oh, really? Is that true?
I mean, sometimes that's a thing people say.
Oh,
but we do
we
have our first caller. I'm very excited. Mm-hmm. Show us on the skeleton where you got hurt.
What?
Who are we talking to tonight?
Can you hear us?
I'm sorry. Yeah, this is Evil...
Who is it?
One more time?
This is Mr. Knievel.
Mr. Knievel! And now I hear another call coming in. I appreciate that. If everybody would do one at a time.
Yeah, one at a time. So what is the bone
you
broken?
What bone have you broken, Mr. Knievel? Mr.
Well, I've shattered my leg.
Uh-huh.
Which right or left and where?
My right leg, fibula.
So that's this guy?
Fibula?
Foot.
Tibia and fibia, I think is what was said. I don't know any of the names of the bones.
I'm seeing femur, I'm seeing fibula. I don't think it's tibula.
Yeah.
Tibia.
Fibula
no,
and fibula.
Tibia.
Fibula.
Right tibia? We're hearing right tibia?
Yeah, right,
right
tibia
here?
And fibula.
So that's
I shattered both of those.
Awesome.
And wait, tibia and fibia?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Fibula. Yeah.
Fibula. I don't know the bone names. I didn't learn them for this.
Uh-huh. I know milk bone and that's it.
I bought this skeletal system poster.
Yeah.
That's the extent of my research.
What are the other bones you've broken, Mr. Knievel?
If any others. I don't want to,
you know.
I don't know if you're in a dangerous
line
of work.
I broke my thumb.
You broke your thumb.
Which thumb, right?
On my
left
hand.
Left hand. Ooh, both sides. That's tough. That's a tough break.
Smashed it with a hammer.
Wow.
Man, that is nuts.
Like, wow, so we're flying through these.
Yeah, we got two right off the bat.
We got
three.
This is fantastic.
And,
now,
I had a compression fracture of my L7 vertebrae.
Ooh, one of those. One of these
L7,
ones.
Which one is number 7?
I don't know.
Is it this one?
Maybe.
I think
that has a 7 next to it.
It does. Okay, I'm going to
great.
Put an X on there then.
No, one up there seems like it's a tough one, like right up by the neck.
Yeah, that seems like bad news.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it bad news when the doctor said you've broken a bone?
Well, yeah. I had to walk with a walker and
oh.
Wow. We were also curious, does it hurt?
Yeah.
What?
Does it hurt? We're safety boys, and
yeah.
So we don't. Does it hurt to break a bone?
Yeah, physical harm.
Oh my
is
gosh.
Something I'm interested in.
Well, I think what happens is that your brain knows that you've been injured.
Uh huh.
So it cuts off all communication with your nerves.
Oh wow!
You go into shock mostly.
Well, sort of. It sort of isolates itself, and unless you look at it, you don't know. You can't really feel the extent of it.
Wow. Looking at a
pretty
broken
intense.
Bone in your neck is probably almost impossible.
Especially the back
right.
of the neck.
Yeah, the back of the neck. I mean, I can't look at it normally.
No.
So maybe
well,
if
it's
I broke
easier.
It's trouble when I'm trying to get that pesky neck hair.
Maybe
just
if
clean
I
clean it up and make my haircut last a little longer.
Maybe if
it's
I
actually,
broke my neck enough, I could look at the back of my neck.
It's actually
did you know that the
easier because it's
broken.
Necks
is owls. You know it's owls all the
time. My brother once tried to convince me that owls aren't smart. Isn't that crazy?
They're the only
they're
birds
the
that
only,
went to college.
They're the only smart animals.
They graduated.
Right.
Anyway, thank you, Mr. Knievel, for calling in. Are there any other broken bones you have?
I've broken like ribs and.
Jeez, can we?
My collarbone.
Jeez, Louise. Which collarbone?
Left.
Left. Great.
Which one is
that,
it?
That one. It's,
this one? This triangle?
It's that one. It's the clavicle. Yeah. There you go. And ribs? Can we just cross out all ribs at that point? We just got a ribs.
Yeah, I don't know which rib I broke, but...
Let's pretend it was that one.
Now, I know after you get braces, you're not allowed to eat ribs. After you break your ribs, are you allowed to?
Or are you allowed to eat braces?
Oh, my gosh.
I'm sorry, I don't want to make fun of your medical condition.
Okay, fair enough.
Hey, guess how much it hurt when you break a bone?
How much?
As much as that joke did. Anyway.
I forgot to say also, I'm happy we've got this call. And it's reminding me, there's another part, another thing our callers can always
Absolutely.
Do. Which is, you can always ask for a riddle from the Jar of Riddles. This is a feature that we have that is going, even though we are requesting as many broken bone calls as we can, you know, if someone calls in right now, I'm sure we'd jump to that call. But since we've already discussed the broken bones, now might be a great time for a riddle.
By the way, you said something that reminded me. I think instead of phone calls, we should take bone calls.
Whoa!
Call in with your bone calls. It's going to be great. Let's bring back this jar of riddles.
The jar of riddles. Now, yeah. Can we entice you?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Go ahead. Great.
From what I understand, from the last episodes, they're pretty easy, so fire away.
Hey, cool.
Hey, hold on.
Our producer, and a look of anger on our producer Cassiani's face. She jumped, not out of her seat because she's sitting on the floor, but she jumped to her knees. That's something.
That's
sorry.
That's some tough stuff.
Okay,
right.
We've got the riddle.
Here's the riddle.
And we don't know these.
I don't have eyes, but once I did see. Once I had thoughts, but now I'm white and empty. What do you think this is? I'll read it once more. I don't have eyes, but once I did see. Once I had thoughts, but now I'm white and empty.
I don't know. Terrifyingly accurate.
This is very odd.
We did not plan this amazing. Now, do you have your answer? I don't want to take the drama, the tension. I don't want to kill any of that.
Yeah.
Is it a skull?
I mean, that's what I'm thinking. Yeah. And our producer is waving her flag. She has a flag. Yes. She has a flag. It's for signaling us. She's waving it. I think that means you have gotten that correct.
That's an A+ number one, Evel Knievel. Wow,
thank
you. Amazing call.
My goodness.
I can't believe that we didn't. We didn't add new riddles this week.
Yeah.
So this is a riddle that was already in the jar.
Wow, this is. I mean, this show was destined to be about bones. The TV.
Yeah,
show.
It wasn't very. it wasn't
way,
as easy as I thought it was going to be.
If you want to talk about the TV show Bones.
Hey, everybody, call in and tell us who you think the king of the lab is.
Yeah. Is it Bones or
it's a
any
Bones
of the other
reference.
Characters?
I got Bones references.
Yeah. Man, the answer was
it's Betty White.
A copy of the first season of Bones. That's pretty nuts. All right. Here you go, Harper.
Okay. Wow. What are we doing every time?
What? Anyway, thank you so much for calling Evel Knievel. That
thank
was your
you.
Name.
No
right?
problem. I got to run or just hobble off, so.
Yeah.
I appreciate
right. well, we
your
appreciate
time.
The
Thank
call.
You.
Does that mean you have broken bones right now?
Those are current. Those are all current.
I'm old. I'm an older gentleman, so I can break at any moment.
Yes, that makes sense.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks
all right,
for calling
thanks.
In.
Mm-hmm. Have a great night.
You too.
Love the show.
Yeah,
thank you.
You know, even.
Hate the riddles.
Bye. Great. Well,
all right, okay.
Well, I guess we've got feedback.
Hey, you know what? If you love the show, you know what you can always do is share it on your page.
Share it on that page.
Especially tonight, a night when we need you to be reaching out to friends that you know are reckless.
Yeah.
Friends that you know have made mistakes.
Wild cards. If you've got a friend who you're like...
you got a wild card friend,
that
tell
guy's
him to call
a
into
wild
him.
Card.
Has Nicholas broken any bones?
I have not broken any bones.
He says he's not.
I'm not sure if I have any. I don't know.
No, he has.
Sure.
I don't think he... He doesn't look like he has.
No.
Now, hold on a second. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. I don't know how to take that. Well, thanks for calling, Knievel.
You look safe. You know what I mean? Like somebody who would get stuck in a
safe.
Tree and not want to come down.
We live protected lives.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I've got a shell most of the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a hermit crab or a turtle.
I had to convince you to not wear it for the show.
Yeah, and it is hard to get out of, too.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty nuts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that was a great call. I think we need to move on to our first segment of the
okay.
night.
Yeah.
Sounds good. Have a good
night.
Thank
you for calling. Have a good night as for you as well.
Yep, absolutely. So our next segment, by the way, during this segment, feel free to interrupt and call in. By the way,
oh yeah, bones. If you got a broken bone, interrupt
please,
and call in.
Please interrupt and call in. So
if
this
you got
is
a broken
our,
bone, call us.
So this is a brand new segment.
Yes,
this is a segment we've
never done this before.
We've
never done this segment before. Brand
and this,
new.
And this involves something that I don't usually do, which is a theme song.
Wow.
Ready?
Yeah.
This is the theme song. This is a segment called Entertain Man.
Yes.
Where we talk about entertainment that we've enjoyed over the week.
Mm-hmm. A brand new segment.
We've never done this segment before. Entertain Man. Of course, that song.
Sure.
Parody of Enter Sandman by Metallica.
Do you want to go first, or should I?
I'll go first. Okay. Now, this is my one piece of entertainment.
Okay, I've only got one piece also.
Great. So this is my one piece
and
of entertainment.
And my one piece is one piece. No.
So, I teased this last week. I mentioned last week.
Oh, you said you were going to have...
I was going to talk about if we did anything like this, right?
Right.
Which I never imagined we would do anything like
this. Who would have thought?
Who would have thought? I'm going to review the new album by musician, singer-songwriter, YouTube personality, Poppy.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Poppy.computer.
It seems like you're navigating to notes on your phone. You have written a review.
No. I just have the track listing.
Okay.
Yeah. So, my first things first, it's good.
Yeah.
It's good stuff. I really enjoy it. A lot of the songs on the album are singles that had already come out, which I enjoyed. My favorite song on the album is still My Style, which was a single that came out. It's very, very good. I really enjoyed the song Software Upgrade, because it's sort of the anti-Computer Boy, which is another song in this album I really enjoy. Yeah, so Computer Boy sets up, she's in love with her computer, and then Software Upgrade is like, ooh, I need a new computer. So, it's surprisingly thematic. I gotta give it a couple more listens to get into to really get into it. It's a great first album. I really enjoy it.
That's great.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. That was my segment on entertainment. Oh, wait, you still have to go.
Yeah, I only picked out one thing as well because I didn't consume that much this week, I guess.
We didn't consume that much tent.
I guess not. The one thing that I wrote down is on Netflix, American Vandal, a show that I had put off watching. I just thought maybe it wasn't going to be for me, but then I just started watching it, and you know what? I thought it was funny.
It's good?
I liked it.
I'm sure.
I'm a fan of Serial. Mm-hmm. I'm a fan of the podcast Serial. Yeah, okay. Cool job. I'm a fan of that sort of true crimey thing, and this is it does a fun parody of that in a high school world. It's funny.
That's cool.
I think it's funny.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's good.
I saw in the comment someone was saying that they watched Mindhunter,
uh-huh.
Netflix show that I considered watching because I was on a sort of true crime.
Mm-hmm. Now someone called a Mindhunter is probably very familiar with
track.
Bones.
Although probably even more familiar with minds.
With minds, sure. Yeah, well, everybody knows that the mind is in the skull.
I'm also seeing in the comments someone says they broke their box set of bones.
Yeah,
now,
I don't know where to put that.
I don't know where to put that either.
This guy kind of looks like the main guy.
David Boreanaz,
yeah. That's the actor name, I think.
It looks like he's wearing a tiny belt buckle that says cocky.
Yeah.
Just another very specific Bones reference.
We've got
because I've seen Bones. Hi, thanks for calling the show. You're on Secret Handshake. What bone have you broken?
I broke, a long-time listener, first-time caller,
first
of all.
Thank you so much for calling. What's your name? Sorry, what's your name?
Christopher.
Awesome. Hey, Christopher, thanks for calling in.
Now, you said that you're a long-time listener. Have you never enjoyed
the show visually?
Yeah, no, I Yeah, I've never actually seen it. I've just listened to it.
Yeah. I mean, you know.
I broke my radius.
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 The bone?
No,
that. Where is that? If you were to describe it in a way that I would understand.
Yeah.
The rib. It's one of the bones in your rib, in your arm.
In your arm. I'm arm, but
What part of the arm? The bit, the this part, the strong part, or the weak part?
I'm looking for it.
The thin part. The thin part.
That's what's here. Muscle bone.
Is where I'm pointing, does that look right? And was it right or left?
Left.
Left.
Okay, so I'm very close.
Closer to the wrist.
Closer to the wrist. Okay.
Okay, so I'm gonna go like right there.
Boom. So we're just gonna say you had a broken wrist.
Thank you for that one. Broken wrist. Pretty good jokes to be made there. So I'm excited about that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Because of.
What's up, man?
Because of using a computer like a nerd.
Oh, sure. Uh-huh.
It sounded like you were going to say you'd maybe broken some others.
Yeah. I have broken my foot bone.
Your foot bone. Now, my understanding is the foot has got a lot of bones. So
was that on the right or left side?
Right side. On the flat part.
The flat part,
okay,
right.
Okay, I got the... Uh-huh. I put it on the foot.
Great, broken foot. Nailed it.
Nailed that.
We are just burning through these bones.
Do you guys want to know how I broke it?
Yeah, absolutely. If there's a good story, I'd love to.
I tried to kick a soccer ball, and I kicked the ground, and I broke it.
You know, some might say, the Earth is the world's biggest soccer ball.
I've heard that.
Yeah. So, I mean, you succeeded in one way, but in the other way, you broke your bone.
I got two more bones for you.
Oh, okay. It's not a two more.
It's a broken bone.
Okay, come on.
I broke my right ring finger.
Oh. What? How?
Got it.
Huh?
How?
My dog bit me.
Oh, that sucks.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sorry.
I'm sure it was an accident.
Yeah. Or did you have a piece of bacon wrapped around your ring finger?
I was trying out a new invention called the meat glove.
Oh, they put bacon on everything these days.
Oh, my gosh. Ugh, I love epic meal time.
That dog sure did.
And the last one, before I gotta go real quick, guys, is that I broke... You can mark another vertebrae. I broke my 69th vertebrae.
Which vertebrae?
I'm going to need you to say that
slow. I need
slow
you to say it again.
And in a voice that it would be very clear for a phone call, which vertebrae did you break?
69th vertebrae.
Okay, now we've gotten a real jokester. We got a
get
jokester.
It's the one right by the balls.
It's right by the balls. Okay, all right, sure. Yeah. I know about that one. Great, so we had a caller who said that they broke their balls bone.
Is that right? I got it right there.
Yeah. All right, awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now, since we don't have someone else who's called in yet, and we've gone through all of your Oh, wait, I'm sorry, we didn't ask for the story. How'd you break the 69?
Yeah, how'd you break that?
Have we lost that call?
Did we lose the call?
That call is now gone. Right. Okay. Great. We did lose the call.
I feel like we got pranked just then.
Honestly, I don't know whether to believe that first guy was even evil comedian.
Oh my goodness. We've got a bunch of jokers calling in.
If you've broken a bone, please call in. We're trying to fill out this whole skeleton. If you've ever broken a bone, call in 8024 two hands.
Absolutely.
Or hit the call now button on our profile.
Just hit that call now button.
Perfect, may have just done.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for calling in. What bone have you broken? And what's also your name, I guess?
Hello?
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, it's Keithan.
Hey, Keithan.
Hey, Keithan, good to talk to you. Have you broken bones?
Well, I wouldn't necessarily say it was a bone, but, like, there was one time whenever I was younger that, like, I thought I broke my cock.
Oh, no. I mean, we already have that crossed out.
This is not a joke. Like, this is a real thing that happened to me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
So, I guess that what we're saying is, we'll allow you to keep speaking. Yes. But, you know.
Medical terms, please.
Okay. So, pretty much, like whenever I was younger, like, young teens or whatever, and all that, like, I thought that, like, I had a hard-on, or I guess I had an erect penis, sorry.
Sure.
Because you wanted medical terms.
Do we gotta cut this out? Do we gotta cut this out?
The medical terms don't make
sense.
No, they don't. I don't know what to do.
Just be gentle.
There was a point where, like some guys do, like, you got, like, this giant, like, wiggle worm down there. Sometimes you do things with it, and it doesn't always work out.
I don't think you need to go into any more detail with that. So, I'm so sorry,
so you tried to break it, and then you're like, oh, it turns out that doesn't feel good.
No, like, what ended up happening was, is, like, you know, like, the penis, like, is technically, like, a muscle, so what ended up happening was, is, I popped my bone.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like, you would pop your knuckles, like, I popped my bone.
Uh-huh, yeah.
I popped the muscle, my penis muscle, sure. And I was like, oh my god, I broke my penis.
Yeah.
Did you have to wear a cast after that?
At the time, like, it was really sore, like, for a couple days after that.
Great. Okay. Well.
I thought for sure I wasn't going to be able to have children, but, like.
Mm-hmm.
I looked it up on WebMD.
Mm-hmm. Well,
I found out that that's something that, like, happens sometimes.
Okay. I've heard it can.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that I was okay, and I breathed a sigh of relief.
Well, thank goodness for that you're okay.
Yeah.
Congratulations for getting through that harrowing experience. Would you like a riddle from the jar of riddles?
I don't know if I can do a riddle tonight after reliving that horrific experience.
Fair enough.
But I figure I'd call in and I'd do it for you guys. I know it's not a real bone, but.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, the most terrifying story we've heard tonight.
Oh, absolutely horrifying. Yeah.
Yeah, like
maybe
this was around when I was like.
You have one of those.
Yep.
I just turned, like, 13 or 14 or something like that.
Oh, yeah, that's a tough age.
It's a bad time for it, too.
Yeah.
Bad time to break it.
Yeah, absolutely. Terrible
not
time.
Not like anything.
And also, it's like, who do you come to, like, with
well,
that kind of...
Well, nobody after that. Okay,
well,
let's
all right,
move on.
Here we go.
Okay,
let's move on to another new segment. Yes.
Wow, it's time now for one of our segments.
Uh-huh. Do you want to go... Would you like to go first?
Keithan, we're going to have to let you go. Thank you so much for letting us know, Ben. Mm-hmm. If you're not doing a riddle, we're going to
put
the phone line.
Thanks
so
for hearing my story.
Yep.
Yeah, thanks for sharing it with us. I'm sure that can't have been easy.
Absolutely not.
No problem.
But we do want to keep things clear in case anyone else who has broken a bone wants to call in.
Uh-huh.
But before that, we're going to do one of our segments.
Absolutely.
Which of us is it going to be?
You're going to go.
I'm first?
Yes, you'll go first. I believe I went first last time.
Now, remember when I handed you that device earlier?
Yeah, it's right over there. Yes.
Yeah.
So this is a weekly segment that Harper does called, what is it called?
It's called Recently Obsolete.
Recently Obsolete.
Yes, it's time again for Recently Obsolete.
And the theme song is, boop, boop, beep, boop, boop.
Never had a theme song before. This is a segment where I review pieces of technology that I've inexplicably kept... Even though I haven't used them in years.
This sounds like an interesting and entertaining segment.
It's one I do every week.
That if I were at home watching, I would share on my page for other people to watch.
Oh, that's friendly of you to do that plug there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, today I'm going to be talking about the Sony Psych Network Walkman, a music player that doesn't have ties to any specific memories for me. So to figure out when I used it, I had to do some sleuthing, which led me to the discovery of something about the Psych that is unprecedented in this segment. I'll walk you through it. Amazon reviews indicate that this device was popular around 2005, but the expiration date on the AAA battery inside suggests I could have been using it as late as 2011. That's a pretty wide window, so I tried to narrow it down. The Psych uses flash memory 512 megabytes of it. So there's no danger of tracks skipping, unlike older Walkmans that played CDs or tapes. That's why, in the product description, Sony invites you to pump up the volume wherever you are, whether pounding the urban jungle pavement or power cycling at the gym.
It says that whole thing.
Yes.
Okay.
It's important to our timeline because music had to be added to that memory through a Sony application available only on Windows PCs.
Ooh.
Sonic Stage, which has been discontinued, and was last updated in 2007.
Wow.
But I didn't get my first MacBook until late 2010, so it's possible I could have still been using the old software on our desktop PC at least that late, which means it doesn't really help with our time window. I think a better indicator of when this was my primary music player is the music.
Ooh.
And luckily, this device still functions. A fresh battery and the Sykes blue blacklit LCD tell me it holds only 3 albums. One from 2004, two from 2006. The Thermals, Girl Talk, and Regina Spektor. The music player didn't have ties to specific memories for me, but these albums do. Sophomore year of high school. Can't have been before, and it wouldn't have been after. This research and these results matter, because they date the last use of this device to late 2006 or early 2007. It's close, but that means that the Sony Psych Network Walkman is the first member of the recently obsolete Decade Club. An honor given only to those rare items that I have not used in over 10 years. Of course, as always, this is all in service of answering two questions. This is how the review works. I answer these two questions. Should I keep this device? And will I keep this device? Now, should I? Clearly, I should not. I haven't used it in over 10 years. I have no way to add music to it, and I can't imagine stockpiling AAA batteries for this. Now, will I? Let me paint you a picture. I'm sitting at home next week when suddenly, my internet stops working. Equally suddenly, I have the inescapable desire to listen to Regina Spektor, and no way to do it. This device could save me from that nightmare. And listen, it's really small. It's not taking up much space, so yes, I will be keeping it. Thank you.
Wow. Wow. Oh,
thank you.
That is a harrowing tale. I said harrowing earlier, and I'm saying it again now. The first member of the Decade Club.
The recently obsolete Decade Club.
God, I want to give that thing a smoker's jacket and introduce it to Alec Baldwin.
Oh my God. The MP3 player that is represents Steve Martin is here.
Yes. That is, wow. That is incredible. Oh, wow.
And that is going to lead us directly into a call, which is fantastic. Tonight we're asking people what bones they've broken. Hi, caller. Welcome to the show. What's your name and what bone have you broken?
You can breathe.
Hi, it's Olivia.
Hey, Olivia. It's good to talk to you.
What?
You too.
What bone have you broken,
Olivia? I'm excited because when we planned this show out, I said, Olivia's broken a bone, so we'll get at least one.
Okay, yes, I have broken a bone.
Okay.
And it was my collarbone.
Which one?
My left one.
We already, have the left collarbone.
Mark this one.
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Here, I'll mark.
Wait, I have a question.
Yes.
Does it count if I broke somebody else's bone?
Yes.
Yeah, it does.
Absolutely. That I totally brought that up at the beginning of the show.
Yeah, you did. Who'd you
hurt? Okay. I broke my brother Alex's nose. So.
You broke his nose?
Really?
Wowzer.
Yeah.
A confirmed nose break.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, with my head, so.
I'll count that as a broken skull.
It seems like a strong unbroken skull.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll say weakened skull. Can we put a little squiggly? Alright, great. How did you break your brother's...
Looks like Homer Simpson hair.
Oh man, that thing is gonna run after Bart and strangle him.
Oh gosh. Just really go after him. Too far.
Oh yeah.
Oh God.
Okay, so how did you break your brother's nose with your head?
Okay, so me and him and my other brother and my mom were all in our bathroom, and our bathroom is not very big. But we were kids, so it was like we fit better. And I was trying to show mom how good of a turner I was, like how good I was at twirls because I was in dance. And she was trying to, I think, cut my younger older brother's hair. And then she was, and then Alex was also in there for some reason. Uh-huh. And I spun around too many times and too close to Alex's head, and I broke his head, face with my nose. Or my head, his face with my head.
It sounds like this story could have turned into your mom stabbed your younger brother's head with some hair cutting scissors.
Thankfully, that did not happen.
Sounds great that you only broke a bone. That is amazing.
It does seem lucky.
By the way, were you a good turner?
Yeah, were those turns good?
No.
How good were those turns?
They weren't.
That sucks.
I wanted them to be.
Yeah.
I mean, I was okay, but I was also like, 5 years old, so how good of a turner could I have been?
That's true. Uh-huh. You don't know how to use the signals at that point. You're just turning the turn signals.
Exactly.
Is there like a left? What's the left one? Is it this?
It might be this. I don't know.
Are they both right-handed signals? I don't remember.
Yeah, I think this is left and this is right.
Thinking of bikes.
Yeah. Anyway. Thank you for calling in.
Thank you so much for calling, Olivia. But I guess we do have another call, so I think we're going to have to jump over to that because we're trying to get to as many bones as we can.
Absolutely.
Sorry to cut you off, but welcome, new caller to the show. What's your name and what bone did you break?
Hi, my name is Cameron.
Hey, Cameron.
And I shattered my leg.
You shattered your leg?
Was that your right or your left leg?
It was definitely my right leg.
We've already. Which part of the leg?
How high up on the leg?
My fibula.
The fibula. We've already got.
Everybody breaks the same parts of the bones.
Why does this fibula even exist if it's getting broken all the time?
It seems like one of those things that we should have gotten rid of, like our tails. It's no good.
Get it out of there.
It's no good.
I agree. Get rid of it. Just take it out.
Did you opt to have your fibula removed?
I mean, I'm making the X bigger.
No, I just had it replaced with a steel rod.
Oh yeah.
Sick.
That is dope. Did you feel like...
Not going to break now,
hey,
is it?
Yeah. Did you feel like...
Hey, Alex.
Who? What?
Alex. Or Nick.
Yeah.
Nick.
Hi, Nick.
This is Cameron Miser.
Oh, my goodness. Hello. How are you?
I'm good, buddy. How are you doing?
I'm all right. How did you break your fibula?
So, playing basketball at school, and, you know, I got crossed up hard.
Uh-huh.
Like... Hard.
Crossed up. I think that means.
Yeah.
I think that means when somebody does like a juke move on you.
Okay. Cool.
Somebody tricks you.
Yeah.
Well, basically yes, but in all reality, like I say that as a joke, but in all reality, I came down from rebound and it shattered.
Okay.
Oh, ouch! Did you make the rebound?
I say I got crossed up because it sounds cooler.
It does sound way cooler.
Yeah. Wait. Did you make the shot though?
I definitely did not make the shot.
Yeah.
It was blocked.
We've got another call coming in, so I hate to let you go, but I think we're going to have to. Thank you so much for calling in.
Okay.
Yes,
thank you. Talk to you in the future.
Okay.
All right,
we're on to our new call. Thank you for calling in. What's your name and what bone did you break?
Hi, my name is Cole.
Hey, Cole.
And I broke my skull.
You broke your skull! We got a confirmed skull break.
How did it
happen? Yeah, I broke it. Okay, well, you see, when I was 4... I was climbing up this high dive, and I decided it'd be fun to fall back.
Nope.
And I fell on the concrete, and my skull kind of broke.
We're getting gasps and mouths being covered by our producers.
My goodness,
that sounds horrible.
That sounds awful.
But it makes a little.
It was.
Sense.
I was in the hospital. Yeah, I was in the hospital for like 4 days.
That seems like the minimum amount of time to be in the hospital.
Yeah,
after
if you break your skull. Yeah. But I guess it makes sense that you were a little bit younger. I think that there was less. The skull wasn't as good.
Yeah, you got a bat. You got a worse skull. Like if you break your skull as an adult, you're gonna grow a new skull.
It's
no.
probably like a parabola of how good your skull is because it's not that good when you're real old. Either.
No, yeah, you got.
Well,
would be my
I
guess.
Feel like. A life jacket kind of, like, reduced the impact.
Oh,
I don't know.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because I almost hit a rod hitting out of the ground.
Oh,
so.
Oh wow, yeah. That, I'm sure it could have been even worse.
Yeah.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah.
Life jackets aren't only for when you're already in the water.
Always wear a life
always
jacket.
Always wear a life jacket.
They're called life jackets, yeah. Not when you're in the water jackets. Yeah. Wear them when you're supposed to.
I decided it'd be fun to fall back, so I guess I wasn't very smart.
Yeah. Now, had you been watching somebody, like, do scuba and get into the water that way? Because that's the thing, that they fall backwards for that.
Yeah.
So, like, was that something you
saw?
Or it was just,
I think I confused the concrete with the water, honestly.
You confused the concrete with the water?
Yeah.
Well, when you're 4 years old, you don't know what stuff is.
Yeah.
Like, hey, these two things are both flat.
Flat, a description, yeah. I've never heard given to water.
Yeah, it is. It's flat. It's horizontal.
I mean, it wasn't the same color, so I mean, I guess that's...
Yeah, that's okay. A good indicator.
I guess that's one of the reasons I was stupid, so...
Absolutely.
Well, and it sounds like you were also four.
Yeah.
So, like...
No, I was smart as a four-year-old. Are you kidding me?
I'd be like, yeah, it's four.
Yeah. I'll say, I'll give anyone doing. A pass at 4 years old.
Do a murder.
But once you turn five,
you turn five, I'm trying you as an adult. Yeah.
It's like, you know, you got a better skull.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. More room for more brain in there. Yeah.
Absolutely. Cole, would you like a riddle from the Jar of Riddles?
I'd love a riddle from the Jar of Riddles.
Ooh, here we go.
Okay, and we do have to go to your segment here in just a moment.
Oh, yes.
We're getting the flag symbol. Okay, so a short one. This is a short one.
Short one.
What belongs to you, but others use it more than you do?
Ooh, I think I know what this is.
I think I might know what this is also. Cole, do you have a guess?
Ooh.
Cole, you're not going to get to guess. I'm so sorry. We got to move on.
The next person gets to guess.
I mean, I was going to guess, like, scrotum or something. But
I don't think that's right, but thank you for calling.
Great.
Thanks for calling in. Do you have an answer to the riddle, or what's your name and what bone have you broken?
Hi, my name is Jackson.
Hey, Jackson.
And, yeah, how you doing? Yeah, I broke, my femur.
Your femur.
Which finger?
It was my left ring finger.
Ooh, left ring
left
finger.
Left ring finger. Were you just trying to get it off? Am I right?
Oh, yeah.
No. I think I'm too young for that a little bit. Just a little bit.
Okay.
Well, see, what happened was is I was playing football, and I jammed my finger. I thought I jammed it, but then I didn't. I broke it. So, yeah. That's
a lot
story.
Of these ending up with sports injuries is the connection I
which
see.
I got to say, and... This leads into sports injuries, leads a little bit into my segment.
Does it?
Yes, it does.
Wow, well, that seems like a transition we can't ignore.
Yes, absolutely. But first things first, do you have an answer to the riddle?
Okay.
I actually think I'm seeing the answer to the riddle in the comments. Yep. I couldn't figure out what this meant until I was like, that's the answer to the riddle.
That is the answer to the riddle.
I think Olivia has it in the comments. She has said. Your name,
which is the first idea.
That was also what I was thinking.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. Cole, we have to move on.
Yes, Jackson.
Cole was the last call. Yep. I am so sorry, Jackson. Mm-hmm. I think we have to move on so you can do your segment.
Absolutely.
But I really appreciate you calling in.
Yep.
All right. See you later, dog.
See ya.
See ya.
All right. So this is a segment that I do now. It's where I review Broadway theater for the New York Times, of course. Ben Brantley is, you know, caught up in France drinking wine and cheese in the same cup.
Ooh, okay.
So this is my weekly theater review. Here we go. Ready? This is for a new musical called Cooperstown, USA. Here we go. The crack of the bat was cracking me up. Cooperstown, USA is the first straight musical I have reviewed, and boy, is it a doozy. It follows the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, New York, a base town with a ball attitude. The show starts out with the history of sticks and balls and how they got started. In fact, this account takes so long that we don't even hear anything about the actual sport until the end of the musical, when baseball inventor Abnus Doubleday stirs in his sleep muttering, "Shortstop, crack of the bat, and a sport where only one person wears a helmet." Then he sits up from his slumber and sings, "Say, that gives me an idea." 90% of the show's budget was spent on a giant, fully functioning light bulb that lowered from the ceiling after he said that. Oh. Casting-wise, this musical missed the mark. Jonah Hill as the stick and the ball came across as closer to fat-shaming than wry commentary on Hollywood. And I know Hugh Jackman can sing, but correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't remember Caveman Who Calls Twigs Tree Fingers having metal claws coming out of his knuckles. That is where the musical ended, or so I thought. After the show, they handed us each a CD with all the songs about baseball they wrote and recorded, but couldn't put into the show. This is the track listing for that CD.
Okay.
A lot of track listings today.
Yeah.
Number one, Bats and Balls. Number two, Stealing Second. Number three, Fly Ball, High Ball, Up into the Sky Ball. Number four, Will Ferrell's Harry Carey, colon, Funny Cause It's True. Number five, Green Square with White Outline and Brown Spots. Number six, 42 is the Loneliest Number, featuring Hamilton's Jonathan Groff as Jackie Robinson.
Oh, dear.
Number seven, Seventh Inning Wretch. Number eight, The Coach and the Manager Are Different. Number nine, Everyone Okays the Cleveland Team Name. Oh. Number ten, Aw Heck, I'm on Deck. Number 11, Lou Gehrig's Gonna Live Forever. Number 12, Someone Drew a Nipple on Mr. Met. Number 13, The Ballad of Pablo Sanchez. Number 14, We Want a Pitcher, Not Another War. Number 15, Women Need Different Rules, Don't Ask Why. That is my review of the musical, the Broadway musical, Cooperstown, USA. Check it out if you want to see... if you want a good time at the theater, you know? Dinner and a movie.
Wow, Nick, I thought that segment was a home run.
Thank you so much. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Well, now that we're through that, we do have a little bit of show left, uh-huh. And so I would like to encourage just a blitz of calls.
Oh, yeah.
Anyone who's broken a bone, please call in.
Absolutely.
802-4-2-HANDS is the number, or hit the call now button on our profile. If you know anyone who's broken a bone, be like, hey, call this number.
Now, here's what I will say. We've gotten a broken bone from every, not bone, but part, like, area of the body. We've got torso,
you're absolutely
arm,
right.
Leg,
I think that's
head.
Something to be proud of. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. I agree with that. And the this part, I don't want to say, you know,
right.
What that part of the body is. But, that's, I think we've done some good work tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we got a lot more of this. We always knew, would we get the whole skeleton? Probably.
Probably yes. We aimed high.
But was it possible?
I don't know. I mean, there are over 400,000 bones in the body. So
looking at this, that seems like it could be right.
Yeah, I mean,
I have no idea which
of
these is connected to which of the others, and that song doesn't help me. And also, I can't tell which ones are small ones that are connected and which is a big one.
Yeah, I don't know if this is two or this is one. Why does this part of the leg have two bones, but this part only has one? See, these are the problems. Like, when I talk to, you know, my doctor, I'm like, what's going on here? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm like, I've seen these skeletons. That's not me.
Has this ever happened to you?
Has this ever happened to you? And by the way, what, like, are these on the same person?
Yeah, I think so. I've sort of been mapping it out depending on where I think it makes the most sense. We do have another call, which I'm excited about.
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
Hi, caller. What's your name and what bone did you break?
Hello. My name is G.
G,
hello,
okay.
G.
And I broke my left toe.
Oh, left toe.
The lefternmost toe?
Yeah, the pinky toe.
The big toe. The big toe,
big
yes.
Toe.
Yes.
World.
It's oh, wow. What a,
so,
what a joke.
Thank you.
That joke for probably.
Yes.
Yeah. How'd you break that toe?
Were you kicking something?
No. I actually just stubbed it on a chair, so I don't know.
Oh, that's tough.
That's scary to me because I'm a big stubber
yeah.
of toes.
Like, if you had said, you kicked something and that's how you broke it, I would have been, well, I gotta quit kicking stuff.
Well, I would have been like, I'm fine because I would never kick.
Yeah, thing. But like, now that I know you just stubbed your toe in a
chair, yeah.
I walk by chairs in my regular life.
Yeah.
Constantly.
Yeah. Yeah. Every day, it's an everyday occurrence.
Chairs are a ubiquitous object.
I'm literally sitting in a chair.
That is so crazy.
That's how
to think about
much of a part of my life they are.
I could stub my toe right now sitting in this chair. Anyway.
Were you wearing shoes?
It really hurt. It just like cried.
I was
going barefoot and I was going to do some laundry and I cry forever.
That is tough.
I'm really sorry to hear that, but I'm so glad that you called in and told us about it so that the pain could be mapped out on this.
Absolutely.
Bone map.
Yeah, so what have we learned? We've learned.
That's a great idea. That's a great question. Should we talk about
that?
Not to stub
your toe.
What we learned?
But we learned don't kick stuff.
Don't kick things. Don't ever do a sport.
Don't do laundry or walk by chairs without protection.
Yeah.
Dude,
don't do anything without
protection. Don't do anything without protection.
Yes. It was the 5th of July, so I was, you know, I just had a party for America, and it was just...
Yeah.
Wow.
It was just, there was chairs everywhere.
So sorry, on the 5th of July, did you become disappointed in your health care?
I don't know.
Because that feels about right.
Yeah. okay, don't do anything with your ring fingers.
Ring fingers are they're the most delicate of fingers.
They're the most delicate finger. You would think pinky, because you're sticking it out all the time.
Or thumb, because it's at a weird angle.
Oh,
maybe you catch it on something.
Yeah,
you forget it.
Yeah, I'm constantly going in and stuff like this.
Yeah, you know how you do it.
Yeah, just like
right.
Absolutely. Wrist. I mean, base. Also, remove your fibula. Right.
This is an extra bone that I can't see a purpose for.
Yeah. I don't know what the term is. There's a scientific term, but I don't remember it. For a bone you don't need. But that's one of them.
Yeah. Bone you don't need? Don't say it.
Vestigial. Vestigial bone.
Vestigial bone. So, we're running out of time. If anyone else has broken a bone, please do call in 802-42-HANDS or hit the button on our profile, the call now button.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, caller, would you like a riddle?
Oh, would you like a riddle?
From the jar of riddles.
From the jar of riddles.
Did we lose the call?
We lost the call.
Great.
Well, I'm so glad. Thank you for calling.
Thank you for calling, G.
Let's set this down for a minute because we've only got a couple minutes left. Is there anything else we wanted to talk about?
I didn't have anything else I wanted to talk about.
I had one thing.
What was it?
I came into some money.
Okay.
I got an email today. I was very excited.
Okay.
I came into some money.
What does that mean?
Well, the Apple iBooks antitrust settlement finally came through.
What does that mean? I don't know what that means. Can you explain it?
It means that I now, in my Amazon eBooks account, have 38 cents.
That is... Wow. You
came into some money.
That is some... That's some high numbers.
Yeah.
That's one of the higher numbers, I think.
Yeah. Okay, that was the only thing I had. But we do have one call. It's going to help us finish off the show. Caller, what is your first name and what bone have you got?
Oh my goodness.
We got two calls coming in?
Yeah, take that first call. Yeah.
You can't do more than one call at a time, unfortunately. Which call got through? I don't know. Is there anyone with us?
Yeah, what's up, guys?
Hey,
up?
How's it going? What bone have you broken?
Well, what'd you like me to start with?
You've got a bunch?
We've got a bunch, just rattle them off.
We've only got 3 minutes. First of all, what's your first name?
Okay, my name is Jeff, actually.
Great.
Okay, Jeff. Walk us through it.
My bone that I've broken is both feet.
Both feet? Great. Just the whole thing?
Yeah.
Awesome.
And then I've also broken my butt.
Okay, your butt. Okay, so that's, that's a tough one to break, too, because you used to sit.
It's the inverse of the chairs.
I know, right?
When you're standing, you got toe problems. Anyway, what else?
The leg that part of the leg that's the upper bone.
Oh yeah,
that one is.
Yeah, the femur.
I broke that.
Left or right?
What?
Was it the left one or the right one?
The left.
Okay, left. Great. What else?
Yeah. And that's it.
Oh, wow.
And that's it? Awesome. You really helped us fill out this skeleton, and I really appreciate it.
No problem, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you so much. We got
a lot further in this than I thought we were going to. You know, we're gonna wrap up now, I think, because we're basically out of time, but we got much further in this than I would have thought. Let's do a quick recap. Well,
yep.
Yeah, thank you so much for calling. I hope we hear from you again in the future.
Absolutely. Love it.
Okay, let's recap what bones we got, you know? We don't have a lot of time.
Well, somebody called me a star in the comments. I like that. All right, so here we go. Number one, with a bullet.
We got skull. Well, it wasn't done with a bullet. That would be even worse.
But, I mean, one of the more important bones.
Oh, I would say.
That's where the ideas go.
Oh, absolutely. I also don't like that there's little hooks here I'm just seeing. It kind of seems like they might be holding up these skeletons.
Yeah, I don't like that at all.
I don't know why that bothers me more than the idea of them standing on their own.
It's like a medieval like posture like fixing thing.
Yeah.
Anyway, next up.
We got nose, the face.
Some might say part of the skull. Then.
I mean, I guess some might.
Then we got the collarbone.
Collarbone.
Both collarbones. No, it's just one collarbone.
It's just one. We put it on
but
both.
But twice. Points.
Yeah, twice. That happened twice. A rib? We got a rib.
I forgot about the rib.
Yeah.
Nether regions.
Uh-oh.
69th vertebrae.
The danger zone, if you will.
Danger zone. Butt.
Butt. The softest part.
One of the softer bones.
We got wrist. We got fingies.
You gotta figure out a way to get calcium to your butt.
Don't tell us that. I'm seeing in the comments someone saying the nose isn't a bone.
Get out of here.
Get out of here.
Please. I mean, please like and subscribe and share. But, so
hands,
we've got
legs, leg, foot, toes. Uh-huh. We did it.
Yes, we've just written a new version of head, shoulders, knees, and toes.
One that's worse and about pain, but we do have to wrap up. We're done.
Yeah.
We're
out of time. All right, here we go. Ready?
Thank you all for watching so much. If you enjoyed the show, please share it on people's pages, because that's the only way for people to watch it, that no one will watch it otherwise.
Broken bones. See you next